Good morning, students and my teacher friends. Today's our topic of discussion is respiratory quotient, RQ. Now, first of all, the definition of RQ. As you can see on the screen, the definition is RQ is the ratio of the volume of carbon dioxide released to the volume of oxygen taken in respiration in the given period of time at standard temperature and pressure. And the formula or the equation for RQ equal to moles of CO2 produced divided by moles of O2 absorbed. There are two more formulas for RQ that I am showing you. RQ is equal to volume of CO2 evolved divided by volume of CO2 consumed, or we can say RQ is equal to molecules of CO2 evolved divided by molecules of O2 absorbed. Now we are starting with our first example. Respiration of carbohydrate. Now, as you can see, this is the equation of aerobic respiration. Now, how we are going to read this equation? So, 1 mole of glucose is oxidized by 6 mole of O2 and 6 mole of CO2 and 6 mole of water are produced. So, according to the equation of RQ, 6 CO2s are produced, 6 mole CO2, and we will divide this 6 CO2 by 6 O2. So, 6, 6 cancel and the answer is 1. So, for carbohydrate, for glucose, the value of RQ is 1. Now, we are moving to the second example, respiratory quotient for fermentation. Now, there are two types of fermentation. First is lactic acid fermentation and second one is alcoholic fermentation. Now, in lactic acid fermentation, no CO2 is produced and no oxygen is utilized. So therefore, for lactic acid fermentation, the value of RQ is 0 mole CO2 divided by 0 mole oxygen. Okay, so RQ is equal to 0 for lactic acid fermentation. Now, for alcoholic fermentation, as you can see, the equation is 1 mole of glucose produces 2 moles of ethanol and 2 mole of CO2s are produced and oxygen is not utilized. Okay, so RQ is equal to twice CO2 divided by 0 O2. So the answer is infinity. Okay, so for alcoholic fermentation, RQ is equal to infinity. Now, for fat, for example, tripalmitin. Now, the equation is like this. 2 mole of tripalmitin plus 145 O2 gives 102 CO2 plus 98 H2O. Formula for tripalmitin is C51 H98 and O6. So from the formula you can make out that the proportion of hydrogen is very high compared to oxygen. Okay, so since oxygen is present in very less amount, we require enormous amount of oxygen to oxidize this tripalmitin. So that's why 145 mole of oxygen are required and only 102 mole of CO2 are produced. So the RQ is equal to moles of CO2 divided by moles of O2 is equal to 102 divided by 145 is equal to 0.7. So for fat, RQ is 0.7. Okay. Now for succulent plant, for example, Opuntia. Now the succulents are plant, they are the plants of arid climate, or we can say they are the plants of desert. Okay. So in succulent, what is happening? Carbohydrates are incompletely oxidized to some other organic acids. What is the meaning of this? For example, this is the formula for succulents. I am reading two moles of glucose plus 3 O2. Oxidation produces 3 moles of malic acid. Formula of malic acid, C4H6O5, plus 3 mole of H2O, and 386 kilocalorie energy is liberated. So RQ is equal to moles of CO2 divided by moles of O2. So 0 CO2 divided by 3 mole of oxygen. So 0 by 3. So RQ is equal to 0 for succulent. Okay. Now for organic acid. Okay. Now we are discussing two examples for organic acid. First is malic acid and second one is oxalic acid. Now in the structure of malic acid, as you can see, more oxygen is present. So that's why to oxidize organic acid, we require less amount of oxygen. For example, in first equation, malic acid is oxidized by 3 mole of oxygen and 4 mole CO2s and 3 mole H2Os are produced. So RQ for malic acid, 4 by 3, so the value is 1.3. Okay. For oxalic acid, the formula of oxalic acid, CH2COOH. So 2 mole of oxalic acid oxidized by 1 mole of oxygen, 4 mole of CO2 and 2 mole of H2O, and energy is liberated. So RQ is equal to 4 by 1, so the value of RQ is 4 for oxalic acid. Okay. Now for protein, in protein less oxygen is present than carbohydrate. So RQ for protein, the value is approximately 0.9. Okay. Now uses of RQ. Okay. So if we are knowing the value of RQ, for example, the value is 1 or value is 0 or value is greater than 1, so we can make out which substrate is oxidized in cellular respiration. So the first use of RQ is, number 1, type of food or substrate being used for respiration. We can get the idea about that. And second thing that we can know from the value of RQ is which type of respiration is going on. Aerobic respiration or anaerobic respiration taking place in the cell. Okay, so these are the uses of RQ. So with this, we have completed the topic of RQ. Once again, I am showing you all the examples. Okay, this is the first example. This is the second one, fermentation. This is the third example. Fourth one, succulent. This is the fourth one, succulent. Fifth example, organic acid, two organic acid, malic acid and oxalic acid. Okay. Images from one another book, carbohydrate, fat, protein, organic acid, anaerobic respiration. So everything we have discussed. So with this, I am completing this topic of respiratory quotient. I hope you have enjoyed this video. My name is Manish Koshti sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye bye. Namaste.